Young babies have it pretty rough, and as parents, we want to do everything we can to help them cope and adapt to the outside world. By making infancy massage part of their daily routine, we can provide a number of benefits to our developing child. I'm Julie Mitchell. I'm a birth doula and a prenatal massage therapist. I also teach infancy massage classes. Today, we're going to be talking about infancy massage. This is Parent Savers, episode 100.
Faster than a speeding toddler.
Sit still for just a minute.
Can soothe boo-boos with a gentle kiss.
Would you get down from there?
Able to clean poopy bottoms in a single swipe.
Oh, what did you eat?
Turning frazzled mommies and daddies into procreators of peace and harmony.
Ah, quit touching me.
It's Parent Savers, empowering new parents everywhere.
Welcome, everybody, once again to another episode of Parent Savers. This is actually our 100th episode of Parent Savers.
Yippee-ki-yay.
And that would be a milestone for some others, but we're just going to keep pushing through with Parent Savers and not even celebrate it too much other than say, 100, whatevs, we'll talk to you when we have 1,000.
Right?
All right. So we're broadcasting, as usual, from the Birth Education Center of San Diego. Parent Savers is your weekly online on-the-go support group for parents from the newborn years through kindergarten. I'm your host, John Arreal. Thanks again to all of our loyal listeners who join us week in and week out. And thanks to those of you who may be listening for the first time. As you may know, you can join our Parent Savers Club and receive access to special bonus content after each new show, plus special giveaways and discounts from time to time. And if you haven't already, please make sure to download the free Parent Savers app available in the Android and the iTunes marketplace so you can automatically have access to all the great parenting advice and conversation we have on Parent Savers every week. Actually, before we start today's conversation on infant massage, let's introduce everyone who's in the room. My name's Johnner, as you guys know, and I have three boys, a 7-year-old, a 5-year-old, and a 2-year-old. And I have zero experience with infancy massage or infant massage, so definitely interested in learning more.
Well, I can't wait to tell you more.
Nice.
Hi, I'm Scott French. I have a 10-week-old daughter, so nice. first baby in our family. So
congrats, and she's here.
She's here with us. You hear in the background.
not a problem.
So. Hi, I'm Jamie French, and yeah, to say I'm Scott's wife, and we actually took an infancy massage class with Julie.
Awesome.
Well, I'm Erin Esteves, otherwise known as OG Mamacita, and that stands for Officially Geriatric, just so you know. I am the producer of the show, and I have one boy. He is 2.5, and no sleep. But before I go on to that...
No sleep is implied.
No sleep is always...
If we're parents, it's implied.
I just wanted to say that if you're listening for the first time and you would like to participate but don't live in San Diego, you can participate virtually. We have a virtual panelist program. You can like us on Facebook. You can send us your questions. You can also follow us on Twitter by the hashtag ParentSaversVP. So go ahead and feel free to comment and send us your questions.
For today's Parent Savers, we're going to talk about a news headline with our panelists, and this is where we look at a story that we've recently found in the news, maybe online, that we think would be of interest for parents and make a good discussion topic. And this one's pretty entertaining. We got this one off Yahoo News, and the headline is, "A Utah Mom Buys All of the Store's Indecent T-Shirts." It happened in Salt Lake City. A mother upset about indecent T-shirts on display at a Utah mall found a quick, if not especially convenient, way to remove them. She bought every single last one of them. Judy Cox and her 18-year-old son were shopping at the mall in Salt Lake City, and she saw shirts in the window of a PacSun store, and they featured pictures of a scantily clad dressed models in provocative poses. So they had kind of pictures of women on them. So this offended. She complained about it to the store manager. Manager said they couldn't be taken down without approval from corporate. So then she bought all 19 T-shirts that they have for a total of $567. And she says she plans to return them later toward the end of the chain store's 60-day return period. Or she'll return them at the end of the the 60-day refund. The shirts cost $28 each on the website. And she says, you know, these shirts clearly cross a boundary and it's continually being pushed to our children. So that's why she wanted to buy all of them. So I think she's kind of a genius because of the return policy.
Yes, that for me was the clincher.
Yes.
Because she's taking, had she not taken them back, I would have been like, well, stupid you, you know, but she's taking them back.
True, but if it only cost $600 to take an important, a stand that you thought was important against
that
merchandising of women.
That store is in our mall here in San Diego, and I actually pointed it out to my husband the other day because I saw the T-shirts in question, and I guess it's that we live in a beach community, but essentially to me, it was a woman in a bra, standing in a bra with her hands on her hips. That's I don't see that as provocative. I don't see that as sexual. but I loved the story.
It's pretty interesting. I think it's pretty hilarious. And I mean, it's in a way of her pushing her agenda and her censorship. Mm-hmm. But it's really not going to end up costing her anything except short-term hit. But she's going to get all that money back.
The money back, but the store's just going to order more because now we're out of product.
Well, and they got the publicity.
They got the interest. Well, right.
This is the shirt that was bought by the Utah mom. But yeah, how come it's okay to go to the beach and everyone's basically wearing their underwear?
Yeah.
When you go to the beach and it's like, oh, whatever. But you don't see it. That's a whole other discussion.
A whole other topic.
Right. All right. Well, we have a link to that story on the episode page on the website. Today's topic on Parent Savers is infant massage. Today we're talking with Julie Mitchell, a doula and prenatal massage therapist. So thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you. It's great being here.
Let's, I guess, just jump right into, you know, infancy massage. What are the benefits of it? Why is it so important? Why is it something that you like to teach, to tell people?
Sure. Yeah. So some of the biggest benefits to massaging your infant helps with prenatal and infancy bonding. Moms get the whole feeding thing, but this is a way for also to get the partners involved in something more bonding. And Scott, I'm sure, will let you know all about that in a minute. But also, like you guys were saying, sleep. This really helps with sleep. Jamie was just telling me off in a little bit that Violet has now slept through the night, which is super exciting.
Very weeks. Yeah, I put her down at 8 and she woke up at 5:15 this morning, so I'll call that a win.
Okay, this is massage, not drugging. Right? Yes, massage.
Although I will say, we don't talk about the no-hitter. I know we're excited, but we don't talk about it, right? Yeah. I'm very happy for you, but I don't want to jinx
it. Oh, and of course, every baby is going to react differently, of course. Another really big benefit that we've noticed with infancy massage is digestion. So babies get gas and colic and just some tummy issues. And with infancy massage, we can really help relieve a lot of that. So it helps with circulation, just like if you got a massage, circulation and all over relaxation. And who doesn't want a nice, calm, relaxed baby? So definitely helps with all of those types of things.
What about, if the baby's fussy?
Yeah, really the ideal time to massage a baby is during that quiet alert state. If they're really fussy, you first want to calm them down.
And so the massage itself isn't a suit.
Once it becomes part of the routine, they look forward to it. Before we ever start a massage, you always say, hey baby, are you ready for your massage now? And once they get used to that, they get really excited about it and they know what to expect. But yeah, you do want them a little bit calmer first before you start.
So if I could just ask a real quick question. So other than, for example, colic, what would prompt someone to start infant massage?
To start, on a daily routine?
Yeah, just out of curiosity, it's like, what prompted you guys to start to go for infant massage?
My mother was telling me about Indian culture and how they massage their babies a lot. And so, it's something that's gone back a long time and something I feel like in Western society we've kind of missed out on. So I do think that there's something to that. And also, I like getting massages.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you like to get massaged too? And so it's a great way. It was actually the massage actually started our nightly routine too. So it was a great segue for us to kind of get a routine for her down. She knows when she's going to bed, just based on that routine, which is nice.
Yeah. So we usually start about 7:30 at night. Bring out the coconut oil, which is one of the thousands of cures for coconut oil as you read every article right now. It's just a great oil and uses for massaging. So we do that about 20 to 30 minutes, start with her feet. So as you mentioned earlier, if they get fussy, well, definitely her legs and her feet, that's like her go-to. You can just grab those at any time, and she's calm. Or sometimes other parts of her body, she may get agitated, but you can always kind of go to the feet. It's always an easy part for her.
Well, and I guess take a step back. What does infant massage mean? Because we're not throwing a baby on a table and putting hot rocks on them,
right? Right. No, we're not doing hot stone on a baby. No, definitely not.
Right. So what are some techniques, or what are we talking about when we say?
So how I teach my classes and how most infancy massage classes will run is you come with your baby, we're on a blanket on the floor, and we start very simply. We start with the feet, and then throughout the series, you end up with a full body massage, just like you'd get, but a little bit different from a baby,
area smaller and all that. So,
right, your hand kind of covers the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah. So, so we just start, you know, kind of kneading in the foot, just like I would on you, but it's a little bit smaller.
Teeny tiny.
Yeah, yeah. And then we rub up the leg, and there's just different techniques.
It's really just
that.
All over touch.
Oh, yes, yes, yes. It's really very similar to you getting a massage. Just the parents are doing it to their own baby in a smaller scale. Yeah. So, but they're, you know, maybe they're on a pillow in front of you on your lap or just on the blanket in front of you. But yeah, we make this part of our daily routine. Like I said, I give everyone coconut oil to start with because I don't want to give something synthetic because babies, what do they do with their hands? They go right into their mouth. So we want to give them something that they can ingest if they do put their hands.
And so do you put a slippery baby to bed every night?
It actually gets absorbed into her skin, so it's not too bad. Yeah, it's not bad. Yeah, exactly. And the coconut oil, it's like, so it's 74 degrees, it becomes a liquid. So once it gets on your hands, it's all liquidy and then it gets absorbed into her skin. So.
And then when the skin warms it up?
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm not that familiar with coconut
oil. You're not. I'm surprised. It's like everybody's into coconut oil these days.
It starts off so pretty solid. And so it starts off but as soon as you put it on your hand, it liquefies.
Got it. Yeah. And so then every night, you guys, before you're putting Violet to sleep, you're rubbing the feet and the...
Absolutely.
Do you go all the way up the whole body?
You know, it depends on the day. Some days are better than others, and some days she has more patience than others. You know, you kind of see what you get of the day. You know, when she just got her shots 2 weeks ago, or a week ago, I'm sorry.
That area.
Yeah, exactly. And knowing that because she was super sensitive.
Well, so what exactly did you do last night? And do it the exact same thing again, right? So, yeah. She slept through.
Exactly. Well, that's her second time sleeping through the night, so I think she's a pretty good little kiddo.
That's awesome.
Yeah, she's now coming up on 10 weeks, trying to get more tummy time. So kind of starting the massages off on her stomach. Yeah. So we're working her back first as that's fresh for her. So that give about a few minutes on her back, rubbing, just relaxing from shoulders on down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And then when she's finished with that, kind of rolling her back over and going back with her feet and arms.
And it's great bonding. Massage. I mean, it really is great. Yeah.
No, it's nice. I think it's something she looks forward to as well. Yeah. It's hard to tell, but she doesn't.
What else
she
you
never
can do? Well, I mean, what else do you really? You don't have that many opportunities to interact, especially dads, with the young babies, other than maybe some tummy time or put them on your chest. So it seems it's really neat to be able to, you know, have that time.
Exactly. This has been a long week at work. So you get home at 7, you sort of, you know, dim the lights in the room and give her a massage, wrap her up after that, and read a book.
Asleep.
And I've been falling asleep next to the
dude. You fall asleep. Yeah.
That feels so really cute. Good, though. It's actually, really fun. So what was the class like? Was it just you two in the class, or were there other couples?
No, it was just us two, which was actually fantastic. Because one-on-one, you know, there's nothing much better than one-on-one experience, so which is great.
You can find group classes. It just so happened that Scott and Jamie were the only couple in this class, particular class. But different couples can come. It can be a group class. You all learn it once. Does get a little hectic. I always tell people that the class will last anywhere between 30 minutes and probably an hour, just depending on what the babies will allow, because they're the boss, not us.
So what benefits are you guys getting as parents?
Well, besides, Scott's got a chance to bond. She has been sleeping really well. And I would say getting that routine established for us was really good, because the structure, it kind of like just grew into like a better routine. Like that routine at night grows into like the routine during the day.
Right.
So she has like certain expectations with that.
Has it led
to
more parental massages?
Not really.
I'm open.
Nice. All right. Well, let's take a quick break here. When we come back, we'll talk about some more of the benefits, as well as, you know, maybe how long infant massage can last for and when you should stop. So we'll take a quick break. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everyone, to Parent Savers. Today we're talking about infant massage with Julie Mitchell. Thanks for joining us again, Julie.
Wonderful being here.
So we were talking about some of the benefits for infant massage, but I think that there's still some more that we didn't quite touch on. So what about, improving a baby's circulation? Has that been shown that that's something that happens?
Absolutely. Same thing with when you get a massage, when we're moving the lymph around and we are moving blood around as well. So so if there's stagnant blood anywhere, it definitely gets moved through the system.
Are there any surprising results that you've heard about from infant massage, that maybe something happened you didn't expect that was positive? are you going to it expecting it to be the awesomest thing in the world? And then
well, like I said before, you know, every baby, every couple, every, you know, situation is going to be different. But I think the overall experience of, oh,
hi, baby.
Violet wanted to be heard too.
Yeah.
She's like, I like my massage. That's don't right. you talk right? bad about it.
That's right.
Before we ever start a massage, we ask the baby, is it okay? So we'll start rubbing the oil in our hands, say, okay, are you ready for your massage today? Is it okay? And even this small, and, you know, Violet started coming, what, 5 weeks, I think.
Pretty much 4 or 5 weeks old.
And there's a clear yes or no. You know, the first couple times they kind of look at you because it's a word they've never heard maybe or something, but they'll either open their arms way up and be like, okay. Or they'll kind of, you've seen babies, they kind of curl up, maybe even roll away from you, and that's a no. And so maybe you just have to back off your question a little bit. How about, can I massage your feet today? And then you'll see babies think about it. It's really, really cool, and it absolutely does say what's appropriate touch and what's not, because it gives them control over their own body. And at this stage, you know, we don't think about it that way as adults, that they should be in control, but they should be. It's their bodies. So infancy massage definitely has a big part of that.
Yeah, it's so like if you were trained in infancy massage or knew about it, is that something you could start at the hospital, or do you recommend waiting until the baby is around 5 weeks, like you said?
Oh, no. Day one is great. Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely. So people can come to an infancy massage class. Really, I say between 0 and 6 months. 6 months because they get really squirmy and there's a lot of other things that are dragging their attention away and all that. So doesn't mean as a parent you should stop massaging at that time. It just means that you might not get a full body massage in, and that's okay.
Would you guys say that you think that she knows? Because part of my impression of really young babies is they don't really understand that those are their hands or those are their feet or what's going on. But it's interesting to hear you talk about them wanting to give you permission or give control. Do you guys see that as you do the massage?
One thing we've done is like work through like her like toes and her fingers, and you know, wiggle each one in front of her, and kind of hopefully it helps put that connection between.
Right, in a way, maybe it's helping her make the connection.
Right, as we work the foot and then the foot, and then you work each individual toe. I'm going to start at like 4 weeks. The toe was super, super small. Trying to get our fingers in there, trying to wiggle each one individually. Now you can tell it's almost doubled. And as she's doubled in age already now. As we talked about, just her gastro stomach, if it's backed up, you can definitely work different ways.
Yeah.
For us to understand how we can do that instead of just saying, oh, she's gassy and she's going to cry all night.
Right.
We can work.
Maybe some ways.
Yeah, gives us a coping mechanism to help her out, you know. Because there's definitely times when babies get gassy and it's uncomfortable for them.
How do we get her knees to her stomach, kind of one of those, and work the stomach through.
So it empowered you.
Right.
You feel like you have something to fall back on, like you said, your coping technique.
Mm-hmm. Right. And also as a new dad, I've, you know, taken all the birth education classes pretty much here at the Birth Education Center, hypnobirthing and some others, but all those courses were really pretty much up to the hospital.
Exactly.
There's really nothing beyond the hospital. So now you bring her home, as you brought the question up, could you do this in the hospital? Yes, now if I had a second child, I could do that.
Right.
As I was learning each of these classes with her, kind of learning each week as we go, how to work different parts of the body. As a kind of new father, I'm like, oh, I don't want to do something to hurt her. And what is good and proper.
I'm jealous because I feel like I didn't play with my baby's toes enough. Like that's really adorable then to think about their teeny tiny little toes and getting in there.
I call them champagne grapes.
They are. That's like the right size. Yeah.
And what Scott was talking about, that's a great way to use infancy massage, is it gives you the confidence to be like, hey, I'm not going to hurt my baby. I can do this and be okay. We're parents. We're new. We're going to make mistakes, and that's okay. But I've seen new dads, you know, as a doula, they're like afraid to touch their babies. Definitely watching Scott throughout the class, so much more confidence about him every week he comes in, which is wonderful.
Absolutely. So you had mentioned, I think, earlier, you know, starting up to 6 months and then you could keep going, but maybe wouldn't have the biggest benefits. But
it would absolutely still have benefits.
Okay.
It's just more that they're so busy.
Squirmy.
Kids are, you know, now I'm crawling, now I'm rolling, whatever they're doing at that stage. There's so much busier.
Yeah.
So it's hard to get in like a full massage.
Right.
But hey, kid, let me rub your hand. You've been crawling around on those hands. Let me rub that. And most kids will at least let you do that at one point. Oh, hey, you know what? I haven't done your back in a while. Let's see if I can get your back in here and there. Absolutely.
What about when they start teething? Is there anything you can do to help that? Like, do you massage their gums?
I don't know any techniques for gum massaging itself, but all over massage releases endorphins that help with pain in general. Mm-hmm. So, yes, there are associations that when you give a massage, it can just relieve some of that pain.
Got it. So for people looking to get started on infancy massage, either locally or if they don't live here in San Diego, a lot of our listeners don't, how can people, you know, find out or get started? Are there meetup groups about it or...?
I'm sure there are. There's meetup groups for everything, right? But really, you go online, and I'm sure if you Google infancy massage and then your hometown, you'll be able to find somebody. Yeah. Absolutely.
So are you still taking classes, or is it kind of you've learned it and now you're done?
I think it was our last. We just had like one sort of wrap-up session left. But yeah, we got all the areas in her head or...
It generally in 4 weeks, we'll go throughout the whole body. So we start with feet and then legs, and then we move up into the stomach and then hands and arms and chest and then head and back. And it's separated throughout the series. And then, like I said, because it just depends on what the babies will allow, some of those classes are shorter than others. And then so we always have a fifth week to either finish what we didn't finish up before or just kind of an all overall, okay, let's do a full body massage together. So if there's any questions or anything.
It seems like, generally speaking, it's one of those things that it's hard to do wrong. It's just the fact that you're doing it.
Absolutely.
Is really the big victory.
Yeah.
For
well, and like
massage.
You were saying about, you know, those stages and everything else, as Scott, I'm sure, is rubbing her toes, you're saying, I'm rubbing your toes. And yeah, it clicks better.
Right.
About, oh, those are my feet. Those are my hands. You know, at 10 weeks, does she know? I don't know. But she'll get there soon.
Well, and any opportunity for contact, I think it's just, you know, beneficial for the family in general.
I think that I need to get out and rub some babies.
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe I shouldn't say that.
Yeah. Is your wife listening?
That's right.
Some Is that other a people's. Euphemism for something?
Some other people's.
No, but I think what I'm taking away from this is that even though my son is 2.5, I can still start this with him.
Yeah.
And
absolutely.
He would be very squirmy at some point, but very, you know, receptive at others.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah.
I'm actually wanting to expand and do a toddler-type class, but haven't gotten there yet.
Great. Well, I'm excited. Sign me up.
Awesome. All right. Well, thanks so much for joining us. Thanks for sharing with us, Scott and Jamie, as well. For more information about infant massage and more information about any of our panelists, you can visit the episode page on our website. We're going to continue the conversation for members of our Parent Savers Club. After the show, we'll talk a little more about group massage sessions for infants. So for more information about the Parent Savers Club, you can visit parentsavers.com.
Hi, Parent Savers. I am Dr. Jennifer Shear, a clinical psychologist with a practice in San Diego. One of my specialties is working with women during pregnancy and throughout the transition to motherhood. Today's segment is on ways to manage the panic we often feel with the sleep deprivation that comes along with baby. There are certain things we all know we should do in order to get the sleep we need. However, actually doing them is a whole other story. We know we should nap when baby naps, let go of the housework, and allow others to help us. However, in order to do these things, we must let go of how we are used to functioning, do battle with the perfectionist inside us, and allow ourselves to be partially dependent on others. Some ways to exercise this necessary shift is to remind yourself that this is an extremely intense, yet very temporary time of your life, to really commit to the job responsibilities of becoming a new mom in relation to sleep. Job is all about baby and self-care, and the rest is interference. Do your best to stay focused on the true priority and guard it like a mama bear. Accept that you will be functioning with a certain level of stress that comes from fatigue, and that's okay. You are still capable of being just good enough without feeling fully prepared or on top of your game. Try accepting this level of discomfort instead of fighting it, like relaxing muscles instead of tensing them when you feel stressed. If it is difficult to allow yourself to feel somewhat dependent on others, recognize that you are doing this in service of being more fully available for your baby. It might be helpful to remind yourself that even if you feel resistant or uncomfortable in these new behaviors, it is all to benefit baby and your own feelings of maternal competence. I hope these ways of thinking about the anxiety with mom fatigue aids you all in having more restful sleep whenever the opportunity is there for you to take. Thanks for listening to Parent Savers.
That wraps up our show for today. Thanks so much for joining us on Parent Savers. Don't forget to check out our sister shows, Preggy Pals for expecting parents, The Boob Group for moms who breastfeed their babies, and Twin Talks for parents of multiples. Next week, we'll be talking about another exciting topic that'll be useful and helpful for parents everywhere, from infancy to kindergarten. This is Parent Savers, empowering new parents.
This has been a New Mommy Media production. The information and material contained in this episode are presented for educational purposes only. Statements and opinions expressed in this episode are not necessarily those of New Mommy Media and should not be considered facts. While such information and materials are believed to be accurate, it is not intended to replace or substitute for professional medical advice or care, and should not be used for diagnosing or treating health care problem or disease or prescribing any medication. If you have questions or concerns regarding your physical or mental health or the health of your baby, please seek assistance from a qualified health care provider.
New Mommy Media is expanding our lineup of shows for new and expecting parents. If you have an idea for a new series, or if you're a business or organization interested in joining our network of shows through a co-branded podcast, visit newmommymedia.com.
Hey, mamas. Don't forget to check out Mighty Moms. It's our online community built for new moms just like you. Not only can you connect with other moms, but you can also join us backstage for special mom-only online events. And you'll also be notified when we're recording so you can join us as a special guest. Visit our website, newmommymedia.com, and click on the Mighty Moms banner. It's free. That's newmommymedia.com. See you there.